6.
Now at 6, the race is on to find this man, a wanted murderer, before any more lives are lost in retaliation. This is a story you saw breaking last night on NBC 15 News at 10.
A 19-year-old man is dead after a shooting on Madison's north side, and police say it's gang-related. Tonight, they worry it could be a sign of things to come.
NBC 15's Chris Woodard reports.
Police say a 19-year-old man was only trying to do his job when his past caught up to him. Just before 10 o'clock last night, a car filled with four men and one woman drove past this business, and one of them started shooting, killing a man standing outside.
Based on what we're hearing from citizens, it's likely that there were members of another gang, a different gang than his, that may be responsible for this crime.
According to employees in this building, the victim had just stepped outside on a break, and there were other employees with him when someone opened fire.
Family members identify that victim as Antonio Perez. And while police say this shooting was gang-related and was not random, neighbors were immediately shaken up.
I never see something like this. Usually I see, you know, police pulling somebody for speeding or something like that, like normal, you know?
Less than 24 hours later, there is no sign of the shooting, but police worry about what could still be coming.
Anytime we have gang violence, there's always the possibility that there could be retaliation, retribution.
Late this afternoon, police released this sketch of the suspected gunman, described as a white Latino male, approximately 5 feet 8 inches tall and 175 pounds. Police believe he is in a rival gang, part of a growing problem in Madison. Police say there are 900 confirmed gang members in Madison and at least 600 associates. Some of the gang members tell them their numbers are closer to 2,500, operating 40 to 60 gang groups. It's a problem that, if ignored, could continue to claim victims. In Madison, Chris Woodard, NBC 15 News.
And we spoke to one family member tonight who is pleading with anyone who has information to contact police. She says until the person responsible is caught, this family will have no closure. And